Hi, I'm Dr. Jason Troyer. This week we're covering chapters 5 through 8 in Confessions of a Funeral Director by Caleb Wilde. One great thing that I want to mention right up front is that you can actually participate without reading the book. Many of the questions can be answered without necessarily knowing Caleb Wilde's perspective on these topics. But there are several big topics that we're covering in this week's questions. One is that throughout the book, Caleb discusses his personal spiritual journey. Funeral service both seems to challenge his faith, but also provide deeply spiritual moments. So I've got a question about how your professional experiences have had an impact, if any, on your personal spiritual and religious journey. Another topic involves something that most funeral directors have experienced, and it's something sometimes with families, the best thing that you can do is simply be present, be quiet, and simply be there to witness and share in their pain and what they're going through. And that can be really challenging. So one of the questions deals with how you have been able to develop your own resources in order to be able to sit and be present with families when all you can really do is just be there in some of those moments. Next, I have a question related to a really powerful story that Caleb shares regarding his visit to a place called Luther Acres Nursing Home. This is a powerful experience because he describes it as the typical process of a removal or transferal at a nursing or skilled care facility, what he calls kind of the back door approach, where the funeral director arrives by the back door, calls in a very surreptitious manner, and everything is hidden away from perhaps the staff members and certainly the residents. But instead, in this situation, they had him arrive at the front door. They brought him straight through, gave him time to take care of the deceased individual and put her on her cot. And then before he left, set it up so that the staff could do an honor guard, and he left through the front door. And he talked about what an important and powerful experience that was to certainly affirm the loss that had happened, to recognize the life of that individual who had been a resident there for a period of time, but also to recognize his part in that process and kind of, by extension, the role that funeral professionals have. And he really felt like they were kind of paying homage to his professional abilities and the role that he was playing in that situation. So I was curious to hear what you had to say about that situation, if there's any facilities around you that do something similar, or if you wish they would do that similar, or if there are any drawbacks to them doing those sorts of things. So there were a lot of great topics in chapters 5 to 8. I hope you download the full question list and go through them. It might be something that you work through on your own and perhaps just do a little journaling. Even better, if you've got a group of colleagues or a fellow students who want to work through it and you can talk through your answers, I hope you'll do that. So please download the questions and go through those, and I hope you'll join us again next week.